podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel podcast, episode 1252. Find the last in each row. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel Netcast. I'm Bill John. Boy, I appreciate you putting up with weeks and weeks and weeks of podcasts in support of the new books. We're now back to just some regular questions sent in by people, either at my seminars or you. If you have a question you'd like to see on the podcast, send it to Bill at MrExcel.com. Now, today's question is someone has an array of numbers. So there's data for weeks going across. And what they need here is the value from the latest week. The difficulty, though, is for each item, some things are filled in, other things are not filled in. All right, now let me show you how we're going to solve this and why it works, so to speak. VLOOKUP, I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with VLOOKUP, the comma false version of VLOOKUP. But today I have an interesting situation here where we're paying a bonus. And if you have a sale over $5,000, you get a $5 bonus. If the sale is greater than $15,000, you get a $30 bonus. $25,000, you get a $100 bonus. So, I mean, just think about it. What bonus do we pay for this $12,000 sale? Well, of course, they get the $15 bonus. But if we do a VLOOKUP, that value, 12,015, is not found in this table. So we need the comma true version of VLOOKUP, which says, hey, go get the value just less than the value that we're looking up. So if we happen to be looking up exactly 15,000, well, it's found, and that works out great. But if we choose some other value, like 25,050, which isn't in the table, it will return the value just less than. Okay, now, so we'll take a look at this, the VLOOKUP with a comma true at the end. You can actually leave the true off if you want to, but I put it there just to remind myself that this is a range version of VLOOKUP. Now, here's the really interesting thing about this type of VLOOKUP. If we ask for a value smaller than the smallest value, like 5, it returns an NA. But if we ask for a huge value, the largest value, just some value incredibly large, it always returns the last item that it finds. All right, so I'm going to use that fact. I'm going to do not a VLOOKUP here, but an HLOOKUP. So equal HLOOKUP. And I'm going to look up a really large value. Now, it's your call what value you put in here. I'm just going to put in, I mean, obviously the numbers are between like up to 99. So just asking for a whole bunch of nines certainly is going to be large enough. And then for my table array, I'm going to choose just this whole row of numbers here. I'm going to go out far enough so that way it'll be further than they ever possibly ask for. And then which row? Well, I want this row. And then comma one, comma true, saying that I want the range match. And see what happens there is it returns the 55. If later on you come along and get another value, 77, that will update to show the next value. All right, so kind of cool there. We're using that true version of the VLOOKUP, or in this case, an HLOOKUP, to return the last non-blank value in that row for HLOOKUP, or we could do it in a column for VLOOKUP. Interesting. So there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.